Hello from Chem Help ASAP. All the bonding we've discussed so far in this playlist has focused upon sigma bonding, but there's another type of bonding that's called pi bonds. So on the left, we have a molecule, ethylene, and ethylene has a lot of sigma bonds. All those CH bonds, those are sigma bonds. But it has this carbon-carbon double bond. The carbon-carbon double bond consists of both a sigma bond and a pi bond. So those two lines represent two bonds. The first is a sigma bond, the second is a pi bond. Where do pi bonds come from? Well, they come from the overlap of p orbitals. So these carbons, carbon 1 and carbon 2, these are both sp2 hybridized. And if you remember, for sp2 hybridization, we said let's take our s and 3 p's, let's mix these together. We will get 3 sp2 hybrids. And those are what we're going to use to make the sigma bonds, and that each of those carbons has 3 sigma bonds, plus there's this leftover p. And the leftover p orbitals, one on carbon 1, one on carbon 2, is how we're going to make our pi bonds. So, as with any mixing of orbitals, we have two orbitals, and we're going to mix them two ways. We're going to add them and subtract them. In this picture in the middle, we're looking at the pi bond, and when I say pi, that is the Greek letter pi. So, I've drawn the p orbital from carbon 1 and the p orbital from carbon 2, and I've drawn them in the same phase, meaning their positive ends line up with each other, and the negative, mathematically negative sides of the orbital line up with each other. And if we overlap these, we get great, and those are our two carbon atoms, we get great interaction in the middle. And actually, you might say the two negatives together, that's a bad thing. That's actually, they're overlapping the same sign. That's really good overlap as well. So what we get is something that kind of looks like this. Don't worry about the picture too much. But this is our new orbital. That's a lot of orbital, but that is all one orbital. That is the wave function for our pi bond. And if we were to square this and draw the probability function, remember our trick. Our trick is just to take all the negatives and turn them into positives. Leave the positives alone. I'm drawing this quickly, but hopefully you get the idea. There's the psi squared. Where would our electron be if it sat in that orbital? It'd be right between the two nuclei. Perfect. Okay, so that's a good bonding orbital. Now, let's do the subtractive interaction, carbon minus carbon. And again, I think of this as carbon plus the negative of the other carbon. So all I've done is I've flipped the p orbital. So we have plus and minus of the first carbon interacting with minus and plus of the second carbon. We're going to have destructive interference right here in the middle. And that gives us something kind of like this. Is our second carbon, and all the orbital possibilities in the middle are gone and replaced with a node. So this is the wave function for our pi star. And if we can imagine squaring that function to get the psi squared, the probability function, we couldn't put electron density in the middle because there's nowhere for it to go. So that's an antibonding orbital. So this is how we construct pi bonds. So there are sigma bonds, and we will see pi bonds. They come from multiple bonds between two atoms.